good morning from the car. Usually I won't start in the car, but you guys were charging all morning. So let me turn the air down because it's so loud. So we are heading to Target because I want to get some Christmas ornaments. There is a box of Christmas ornaments that I have been eyeballing, and I need them in my life. So we're gonna go grab those. And since we are in the car and I want to listen anyway, I thought that I would give you guys my Audible pick of the month. You guys know that I've been partnered with Audible forever and ever, and the majority of the time that I am listening to Audible, it's either when I'm going to sleep or in the car when I'm by myself. So before I tell you the book that I'm currently into, if you want to try Audible for yourself, you guys can go to audible.com/Nicole, or you can text Nicole to 500-500. And I tell you all the time, but Audible has an unmatched selection of books. Anything you want, it is there. If you don't like a book, you can return it and download a new one, which is my favorite because honestly, sometimes you just don't like every book that you download. But the book that I'm currently listening to is The Queen's Gambit. Yes, yes. But I was talking about it to you guys in my last video where I was getting ready to watch it on Netflix. I did watch it, and that's how I found out that there was an actual book, because I saw that it was based off a book, which I didn't know. So that's what I'm currently listening to, and it is so good. I just feel like you get so many more details in a book than you do in a show. And I wish I would have listened to the book first before I watched the show, but it is not disappointing. So I'm gonna listen to a little bit of The Queen's Gambit while we head to Target. And if you guys wanna listen, again, you can go to audible.com/Nicole, start downloading, start listening. Legit the most relaxing thing you'll probably do today.
It was only when he rose and said, "Hello, Beth," that she saw it was Benny Watts. The hair had been long in the cover photo of Chess Review a few months before, but not that long.
So this isn't Target, this is actually Home Goods. I gotta run in real quick because I bought some ornaments here that I didn't show you guys because I came the other day, but two of them ended up being broken, so I'm just gonna take them back. And then we're gonna hit Target just to grab those ornaments. I'm literally only going in for the box of ornaments, and then I will see you guys at that. This picture sold me right here just because I thought it looked vintagey. It reminded me, sir. They felt like nostalgic ornaments, so you, can I help you, sir? Like, can I help you? But yeah, I was pleasantly surprised. The bulbs were super big, the light bulb ornaments. Like, I thought these were just regular size Christmas ornaments. And I like that there's like a variety of texture. Some are like stuffed animals. Some are like ceramic-y feeling, plastic balls, big balls, shiny balls, glittery balls. So pleasantly surprised. 85 pieces. I didn't even use all the pieces on my tree, and it looks pretty full. So let me show you. Let me show you what it's looking like. He just looks a lot happier now. Sir. Oh, who's the baby? I did have like another ornament kit, but it was like a little more like classic Christmas, like plaid and stuff like that. I can't take you right now, sir. I just can't. You're so fucking cute. It really looks like an I Spy Christmas tree. And please tell me you guys know the I Spy books that I'm talking about, because this picture is it. Like, they just need to be closer together. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. So I'm gonna finish doing some laundry. I will see more of you guys tomorrow. I know that today was just, hey, hi, how are you? I decorated my Christmas tree, but I'll be better tomorrow.
Let alone our best friend.
Oh my god. I asked you guys this morning on Instagram what tree picks were called. I didn't know what they were called. Now I do. So if you didn't know, the filler that goes in between your Christmas tree, they're called tree picks. So I didn't know, and I appreciate all of you for telling me. You guys are so fast. Jeremy just left to wash my car, and then when he comes back, I'm gonna run to Joann's and see what they have, because like, no shade to Michael's, I think Joann's is like, their holiday decor is just like a tiny bit cuter. And then check to find if I can, check to find, yeah. And then check to find. And then check to find. And then I'm gonna go to Joann's to see if I can find any tree filler that will go with this like little vintagey tree vibe that we've got going. That makes me, again, just so, so happy. And I wish I had like tips and tricks for you guys on how to keep your cats out of the Christmas tree, but I don't. Like, I feel like my cats are just angel babies and they don't mess with the Christmas
decor or decorations or really anything. Like, they've never tried to climb the tree. Maybe they'll like swat it, but like rarely ever. But no one's like ever climbed the Christmas tree or got inside of it at all. I feel like I get that question so much. It's like, how do you keep your cats off your decor? And I'm like,
I don't do nothing. They're just sweet. Sweet babies.
So yeah, I've already had a coffee and all that jazz. Now I'm trying to get my water intake up.
3 hours later.
Allergies on level 100. I wanted to go to Joanne's today, but I legit haven't been able to like do anything. So I'm just gonna chill. Hopefully tomorrow's a better day than today. Yesterday, I was dead all day. I didn't have any allergy pills here, and then I found Benadryl. And I was like, well, I'm desperate. I'll take anything at this point. I don't like to take Benadryls because they just knock me on my ass. So I was like, not even able to stay awake. We went to sleep pretty early. I was like, well, I'm gonna take a shower and because I'm gonna try to stay awake. And I was like in there washing my hair with like my eyes closed. It did kind of take my allergies away, but I do still feel them here. But my allergy medicine should be here today. So thank goodness. Tell me why I thought that I ordered Christmas lights to put around my garland and I didn't
hey, nice baby girls.
So yeah, I had to order them. I'm like looking all day Monday, like where are my lights. You probably should order them if you want your lights to show up. We have a bunch of errands to run. We need to go to Publix, Target, Joanne's, and the Christmas store. I have to get some like just last minute things for Thanksgiving tomorrow. Beebs wants a pumpkin pie, so I'm gonna go get a pumpkin pie, and he asked me to get him like, he needs like sage and rosemary. I don't know what he needs, but he needs some things. And then I'm gonna get a manicure at 4. So.
Well, good morning. Orangey says hello.
Special baby boy. And I wonder why I have allergies, right? With the camera, there's like a big square and it's like going all over the place. I really need to get a new vlogging camera too. Still contemplating whether we're gonna put the big tree up because I just don't have enough ornaments, and that tree is so big it would need so many ornaments. So if I do put the tree up, I'm thinking maybe only lights, but I want to get white twinkly lights. You guys are killing me right now, like, oh, I love cats.
Do we need another kitty?
No, for you. And we just got like a little turkey, like a tiny turkey breast, because turkey's like actually my least favorite part of Thanksgiving. Like, I like all the accoutrements that go with the meal. I'm gonna make a apple pie. Well, it's not an apple pie, it's like an apple. It's, y'all will see tomorrow. I think I have everything I need to make that. So I think it's coffee time.
Do you think it's coffee time? Do you think that it's coffee time? Two floofs.
I have these emoji stickers here for me to look down. Sometimes it works, a lot of the times it doesn't. But we gotta go to Publix, so got to bring the bags. I feel very proud of myself when I remember to bring my bags. All right, let's go. Watch the house, Nuggets. It would be smart if I remember to bring my mask with me. Trying it again. Alright, shall we? Nope. We're in the same situation as last time. Forgot to put lotion on. Calling around with the cats.
It is such a beautiful day outside.
Alright. Knees are moisturized. Breath controlled. Now we can go.
What the hell?
Let's go. So we're gonna go to Joanne's first. First, look around for some Christmas. What are they called? Tree picks. Christmas tree picks? Not the name I would think they would be called.
Hold on, let me eat this thing. I know that I said we had to go to Target, but I've been like racking my brain thinking like, why do I need to go to Target? So if I can't think of like an actual reason why I needed to go, we're gonna skip Target, because otherwise we'll just walk in not eating anything. The red eye will hypnotize us. $367 later, we're gonna have a bunch of stuff we didn't really need. And then to Publix last. I hate going to the grocery store. You guys know that though, right? I swear to God, somebody just yelled out the window. What? Everybody's looking her out. Everyone's like, what the hell? All right, sir. Tell us how you really feel. Also, I hope when I go to Publix that they have what I need. And I was asking Jeremy last night, I'm like, he's like, you gotta get me sage and like other stuff. And I'm like, okay, where is that? That's in the produce section. He's like, it's by the garlic. I'm like, where the fuck is the garlic? So I'm sure I'll be ringing him up. He's playing like some Thanksgiving, pre-Thanksgiving scramble golf situation. I don't know, but I am excited to make this like apple. I know I keep talking about it and then I'm like, y'all gotta wait to see it. And like, I hope that it comes out good because I feel like I'm working y'all up to my Thanksgiving dessert and I've never attempted to make it before. So. I really want to know what that man yelled out the damn window. Maybe we'll hear it on the vlog.
Okay, babies, I love you.
Alright, I love you. Drive safe.
Alright,
mom. Yeah,
call you later.
Alright,
bye.
Where should we go? We should walk around. Oh, my back hurts. I saw a meme today. It said, you are what you eat. And it said, well, I don't remember eating anxiety and back pain, but okay. And I put one on my story that's like me Googling a phone number instead of answering it. And it's nice to know that so many of us do it. Because anytime I would see something like that, I'm like, oh my God, do other people do this? Because I do it all the time. If some number calls me that I don't know, I just Google it. But all y'all in my DMs being like, yeah, that's me. So we're in this together. Scoot.
Okay, let's go. A few moments later.
Are we surprised that I didn't find anything?
No.
I feel like they had a ton of the tree filler picks, whatever, but I couldn't find any that I felt went with my vintagey looking Christmas tree I've got going. So I didn't want to like put it in and like throw off the theme of my tree. Maybe the Christmas store will have better accessories. I doubt it. I feel like the Christmas store is really only good for lights and Christmas trees. Maybe some ornaments. I'm gonna scope them out. We've been at this light for so long that I think I've aged since sitting here. Anytime. Light. Anytime. Tell me why my muscle memory kicked in and I pulled right into Target when we're supposed to be going to the Christmas store. We're not supposed to be in here. Nope. Okay, bye Target. Bye. Toodaloo. We escaped the red eye this time. I did say we were gonna go to Target. But sorry, I didn't realize you were trying to get over here. That was not nice of me. Parking or nah? Ooh, up on a little hill. All right, now we got a 45 minute walk. Stay in there forever. So I only got the two hot air balloon ornaments. They were too cute. I couldn't pass them up. And then I got three sets of lights. Which, do I want to wrap the garland in those lights? We can cut down the back road or something. I'm not really good at that, like taking shortcuts. Beeps is really good at it. He'll be like, oh, we can turn here and this will go through and cut and cut. And I'm like, oh. No outlet. We need to turn around. What are we doing? Oh my god, this is like a private road. Sorry. It's just so mean. We're going about looks. Wing house. Can y'all believe I used to work there? Look at this girl out here. Cheeks out to the world, right on 19. Hong Kong. That's how they get people in. Oh man. I worked at Hooters, Wing House, Lugs and Jugs. Hated all of them. They'll see some girl in the restaurant and they'll literally just walk up and ask you if you want a job, and that's what happened to me. And the first day, I think I was like 18 or 19, the first day on the job, I walk in the back to get my uniform, and the guy is like, so what size shorts do you wear? And I'm like, probably like a medium. And he was like, all right, well, here's an extra small. Okay. And I remember that I quit because you always had to have your hair down at Wing House. You could never wear your hair up when you were working on the floor. I think I had worked a double that day and I was just hella tired, and I was cleaning the back game room. I swear to God, it was like a freaking wrestling night, like some kind of WWF pay-per-view extravaganza. And those nights were the worst because people would come in so early and just camp out and sit there forever. And I was in the back cleaning, literally on my hands and knees, and I put my hair up into a bun, and like 5 minutes later, there's nobody in the restaurant, y'all. 5 minutes later, the manager comes over to me and he's like, your hair needs to be down. I said, finish the fat bats yourself. That's from Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead when she quits at Corn Dog or Clown Dog, whatever it's called. Yeah, I was like, you can finish this yourself. Come tell me to put my hair down as I'm on my hands and knees picking up chicken wing bones off the floor. I quit so many jobs, y'all. We should ride around one day in a vlog and like go to all the old places that I used to work, because there's a ton. I still think about that guy telling me to take my hair down. Excuse you. One time when I was working at Sunny's Barbecue, I worked there in high school, I always worked the drive-through, and somebody fire in the hold me, like fire in the hole. They ordered a large sweet tea, came around to the window, I gave them the sweet tea, they yelled fire in the hole and bomb the sweet tea all over me, covered from head to toe in Sunny's Barbecue sweet teas. I was so mad. I like hit all. I was filling up sauces all the time and I whapped all the sauces off the counter, and then of course I had to clean them up, so I just hurt myself there. All right, we're about to pull up at Publix. Wish me luck that I can find where things actually are. Sir, is that necessary? I'm a wife. That wasn't as bad as I thought it was. I meant to get myself a sandwich and I just said, skirt, and left. So, I'm starving. Tiny little human in the store. He was probably like 5 or 6, and he was a bite, and he was in the oil aisle, and he was lifting all the heavy oils, and I was standing there looking for peanut oil, and they didn't have any, and I was like, shit. And he was looking at me, and he was like, I'm so strong. I'm like, you are so strong. And he like kind of fell, so I was like, ah, little dude. And when I went like this, I looked and I saw the peanut oil pushed all the way to the back. So that little boy was my Thanksgiving angel.
Holds an hour or what? I locked the door, right?
So it's about 3:54. Our nail appointment's at 4 o'clock, but we make it on time. And I'm feeling red. Tell me why I'm feeling red. I feel like it's because I have my natural nails and I can only wear red if I have short nails. And I've been going between red and orange, but orange, I don't know if I've got that in me, even though red is more intense than orange. I don't know, depends on the color scheme, right? But yeah, I'm feeling red, cabaret red. And if I pick a nude color, somebody slap me. I just started getting my like manicures here, and I don't want to be like, hey, do you guys mind if I film in here? But maybe I'll try to sneak a little footage on my iPhone. If not, I'll see you guys when I get out. So before, after, I did it. We committed to the red. Very happy about my choice. I don't know what it was, guys. I don't know what color red this is. All right, I'm gonna quickly run to my mom's house because she wanted me to come over. She got like LED light strips, and I don't know, she says she needs help putting them up, so I'm gonna go help her do that. And she also got me this really cute pie thing, which I'll show you guys. It's like an actual thing to make, like bakeware. Is that a thing? But it's really cute. I'll show you guys when I get back in the car. It looks so beautiful. Look outside. Y'all just let me look around and give thanks. The more grateful you are, the more happy you'll be. I promise you. Listen, being grateful takes work. Being positive, being happy, like all that takes work with your mind. So don't neglect your mental health. Give thanks. The more thankful you are, I promise you, the more happy you are. And you can be thankful for anything. Like, I'm thankful for the shoes on my feet. I'm thankful for the air that I breathe. I'm thankful for the roof over my head. You can be thankful for anything. Like, I'm thankful for a grape. Just give thanks. It's a beautiful day, and I'm just grateful to be here. So I will see you guys in a little bit. I'll show you the pie pan. I don't really know what it's called, but I'll show it to you when I come back. The sun. You guys know my mom has 5 cats. Oh my god. And of course I can't resist a cat, so I'm on the ground rolling around with them, and now I'm dying. Hopefully my allergy medicine is there because I need it stat. I might even have to pop a Benadryl because I'm freaking dying.
A few moments later,
in the short car ride home that it is from my mom's house to here, full-blown allergy attack, like crying full tears. I love that for me. Side note, how good does that look? But here's the pie pan that she got me before I completely combust from allergies. How cute. I'm gonna see y'all tomorrow.
Morning, it's Thanksgiving. It's like 10 o'clock. This is the before, non-made, and then I feel like it doesn't look like we have anything to eat.
Sweet potato casserole.
Sweet potato.
Stuffing.
Mac and cheese.
Green bean casserole.
Yeah, I hope so. Gonna start his mac and cheese before he goes outside and works out. Look, so we could get crazy.
Sparkling cider.
What is this we're working with first?
Shop cheddar.
Two things of shop?
I don't know how much we need.
Gouda. And you gotta have the parm in there.
A little parm.
You gotta have the parm.
Nice.
During the noodles. Holy noodles.
My mind.
You might want a little heavy?
Too many noodles.
It's okay, I can eat leftover mac and cheese. Who loves the camera? Shrimp. Shrimp loves it.
That's a lot of freaking sharp cheddar.
How about a little Gouda?
Pony.
This is a very soft.
Oh,
cheese.
Cheese. This is what I get to do.
Sous chef.
Have you ever seen anybody pour flour this good?
That big?
This is good. Have you ever seen anybody pour flour that good?
No, that was very good.
Oh, I love how flour smells.
Stinks.
Mmm.
Stinky cheese.
I love it.
We have to make a roux.
Which is butter and
flour.
Flour.
Sprinkle that in for the sous chef.
Oh, shit! Do you need more butter? No?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Another
I'm just gonna bring the thing. Hey. It's just us.
We went a little overboard.
It doesn't even fit in the... What is that called? Colander?
Colander.
Hey.
Fishy, fishy, fishy.
I did it again. Are any of these creamers open? Did you finish one off?
Yeah, big
one. Big one's open?
Ooh.
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 Cheese sauce? That's good.
I done did some over here.
What you did? That's delicious. You didn't even use all the damn cheese.
Well, this is pretty cheesy, my friend.
Ooh.
Cool, one more.
Mmm. Mmm.
Oh, yeah, that's it. That's what you want right there, Beach. Ready?
Ooh. Cheese sauce, check. Oh. I didn't know we were doing baked.
Yeah, we're going crackers on top.
Mmm. Macaroni in a pot.
Yeah. I think I done did something right here, B. Let me tell you. How does that look?
Where's the elbow?
Sweet potatoes.
They gotcha?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Burnt me sous chef.
I'm out of here. Hello.
Go mess with those switches over there. One of them turns this plug on.
All the way over there? Or this one?
All right, let's do it. Sir? Oh yeah, sous chef beeps.
This is weird. I can't even see.
Oh, that's little.
That's
only good. Two of us.
Yeah.
Back to peeling potatoes.
Wanna peel some?
I'll try.
Get mine.
Huh?
Get me peeling them first.
Oh, and then you're gonna try me and be like, look at you.
Oh, you got it, Beeps. Come on. Nothing.
Gary.
Yeah, like I'm gonna cut my finger. Beeps, you think this is funny?
Cleaned it right off. Yeah, those little ones are tough.
Yeah.
Here. Hams, yams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkey. You got a name?
You saved all the little ones for last. What Jeremy did.
The straw got caught on all my ingredients.
Look what Jeremy, on all your ingredients?
I didn't mean it.
I know. He's moved on to supposed to be checking on the oil.
Nothing crazy happening.
Smells good. Smells real good.
We are mashed.
It is smelling good in here. B just went out to check on the turkey. He's a little bummed because we Instacarted some stuff the other day and they were supposed to bring us mushroom soup and they brought us French onion. And so he can't make his green bean casserole. Yay. I was telling him about the soup dilemma.
That was the
Instacart people.
Maybe I ordered it.
No way. You just put whole pecans on there like that? Mm-hmm. Oh, everything smells good.
Somebody's hungry.
You being stingy with the mallows?
You like a lot on there?
You don't? You don't really like marshmallow. Oh.
Okay. Mine's our green bean casserole.
Wendy's. All for me.
3 hours later.
Hey,
what's going on?
Who are you trying to creep on?
What's going on?
I got the item. What is that?
It's apple pie bake.
Oh my lord. Turn off the camera. I'm eating it all.
Ooh. Good morning. Do you ever just catch a glimpse of your forehead and you just are like, So I don't have like any set plans today. I do want to work on some of my Christmas decorations. I finally got my lights in from Amazon, but now I'm like, I don't know if I want to put those on or if I want to put these on. These are the ones that I got from the Christmas store. So I'm very tempted to take all the balls off and string these lights around the tree just so it's like more twinkly, even though he looks pretty twinkly from over there. And then I don't know, I want to make some pots today, like actual pots. I got a pottery kit. Let me show it to you. So another Instagram ad got me, but it's called Sculpted Pottery Guide, and you can make a pinch pot and a plant pot. So it gives you step-by-step directions.
And then it comes with a bunch of clay. So this is air dry clay, which is nice. You just leave it out to dry overnight so you don't have to put it in a kiln or anything. Then it comes with two paint brushes because after your little pottery is dry, you have to put this like clear white paint on it. And then it comes with the tools that you need to like sculpt whatever you're making. Obviously you don't have to make the two pots that it shows you, but it gives you all these tools. And then it gives you a little sponge so you know you can get it wet, so you can get your whatever you're making, you can get it nice and soft. I am also looking into getting like an actual pottery wheel. I know, but I really want a wheel, but they're really expensive. So I've been trying to find a used one, because then I feel a little bit better about getting a used one, because one, it'll already be like messy. I'm weird about like messing up new things. It came with two bags of the clay, so you have enough to make, you know, a couple of things. And then I got an extra bag, so I have three bags of these. Definitely redoing this, so why don't we just start right now instead of lollygagging. I'm gonna take off all the plastic because I have plastic balls that look like glass balls, so I'm gonna take off all the plastic first and just put them in here. This camera just cuts off whenever it wants. All right, there we go. See what I mean? Like, I'm gonna go up and down instead of around, because I think it'll just be a little easier.
What's going on in here?
Look at the sweet.
Oh, nice. Took all those damn ornaments off of it.
Yeah. Oh my god, she looks so cute.
Alright, here's the tree before. I gotta charge you guys up because the battery's gonna die. But I just put all my glass pieces on and now I'm gonna put all these plastic balls around it. I didn't update you guys on this like apple cinnamon bread pudding thing that I made last night. Heaven. It's so good. Mm-hmm. It definitely could have used more apples. And the recipe only called for two apples and I used four apples. And it could use like six apples. I think next time I make it, I'm gonna try to make some kind of cream cheese. Like frosting, because I put the frosting from the actual cinnamon rolls. It just wasn't enough.
Oh Christmas tree.
Y'all, I have on actual clothing. Like I'm wearing jeans. I can't. I don't know what I was thinking this morning. I just saw these jeans sitting there and I was like, let's get dressed. Let's see what that feels like. We are headed to my sister-in-law's. She lives about 30 or so away from us.
Excuse me.
Alright, I didn't get to chat with you the entire time because the sun was not cooperating with us. But I'm here. I'm gonna pick up my niece and my sister-in-law, and then I will take you guys with us inside when we hit some antique shops. I'm really hoping that I find some cute antique Christmas balls. But you know what we need to do first? Like, I need like some chicken nuggets and french fries or something. Let me see what my 7-year-old is wanting.
Shit, let me button these pants up.
I gotta keep it real with y'all. I had to unbutton two buttons, okay?
Not only am I wearing jeans for the first time in 3,000 years, but they're high-waisted. All right, I'll see you guys at the antique shop.
I'm bored.
Oh my God, take a nap. Bringing his brooch home. I told her to tell me when she sees ornaments.
There's ornaments.
Ooh, we're in the Christmas section now. Yeah. See, like, these are the kind of balls that we hung on the tree when I was little.
Yes.
Girl.
You told me to say, they think there's ornaments.
But we were already in. Oh my God, you break it, you buy it.
There's ornaments.
Oh, these are really vintagey. All right, I'm gonna bust you in the head, girl. Evelyn clearly thinks it's cooler up here. Which way you want to go? This way? This place is not joking around, y'all. This is coming home with me. All right, I gotta go. Evelyn wants to go to Chick-fil-A.
Excuse me, does that mean that I get extra candy?
That means you get extra, you can get whatever you want with those $3. You don't really like the fries, do you, Bean? You want fries?
Yeah,
here, take this, set it back there. You got napkins?
No.
Here you go. Some paper straws?
Yes.
My Chick-fil-A doesn't have these.
County.
I'm in Pinellas County too, girl.
No, they're supposed to though.
Really?
Yeah, some of them you go to though and they don't. I've noticed that.
Oh, shit. Woo!
Crispy?
Woo, crispy. Fresh Dr. Pepper.
Daisy, can you pull your chair up?
I'm sorry, I have long legs, but yes.
We got something the other day. It was like,
got room?
I was all ready to eat.
I didn't even realize it was Small Business Saturday, too, so I'm feeling pumped that we went to some antique stores. We really only made it to two because it's hard to go antiquing with a 7-year-old. I got this little ring holder, which I love so much. I feel like I had one of these when I was little, but you guys know that I went through Hurricane Andrew and I lost a lot of stuff. If I didn't have one like this, my grandmother did, so I just love it. This little catch-all dish, which I just could not resist. I love it so much. This is like my most favorite thing I got. Passing the first antique store that we went to, they were doing like pottery classes, like with a pottery wheel and all that. So I was like, I feel like we were meant to go to that one, because I was telling you guys about me wanting to get like an actual wheel and start like throwing my own pots and stuff, but I have no idea how to do it. So I was like, well, maybe I can take some classes first. And they have classes right there. There wasn't a ton of Christmas ornaments, and if there were, they were just like not, they weren't like worth buying because they were just like dusty and rusty. Legit dusty and rusty. I went a little crazy in Five Below and got all these candies. It's fine. we gotta let these high waisteds go. Can't wait to get this shirt. I cannot wait to put on some sweatpants when we get to the house. I feel like I can hear my Sublime tease from here. Come back to us.